All right, now, to exercise that diaphragm. Did you do it tonight? Oh, you did it already. Okay, we'll do a little with everybody. Good breath. We don't lift the chest. We don't lift the shoulders. We just take a breath as the baby breathes, like this. And the lungs are filled. The lower part of the lungs are filled. No one can crush our ribs. We've done that experiment many times because it's like a balloon of air in there. Breathe. Ha, 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 ha.
And we are experiencing it in the ashram and here
Every week, something new is descending. Descending with the power of transformation, because it is through Om that it is coming. And there's so much written by Sri Aurobindo on Om in the Upanishads, by Mother, who says Om is the signature of the Lord. And it has such a power that it can heal and transform. Going through this collective body into the earth and its waves radiating and vibrating through all the earth, and the Om choirs that are coming up in Germany, in France, in Belgium, in Russia, in Australia, in the US, in Ireland. It's a wonderful thing. And one day we will join all of these when we have our internet experts hooking us up all over the world. And we have an Om for the world. Tuning. We begin, and each person tries to match exactly the timbre of the person on either side, and then we extend our consciousness to the whole collective body.
Oh.
to those who have difficulty hearing or reproducing the chord, this is only during the exercises. When we begin the Om, everyone joins in the Om. This is just preparing us. So everyone is welcome to sing the Om. It doesn't matter what your voice is like, because he is receiving our aspiration, our prayer, our devotion. So everyone is welcome to the Om choir, whether they can sing or not. Even if they just want to sit and listen, they're welcome.
Thank you. This is the passage in which the God of love meets Savitri. Love in her was wider than the universe. The whole world could take refuge in her single heart. The great unsatisfied Godhead here could dwell. Vacant of the dwarf self's imprisoned air, her mood could harbor his sublimer breath, spiritual, that can make all things divine.
Oh.
Death in his powerful voice almost shouts at Savitri. Know also, and knowing, thou shalt cease to love and cease to live, delivered from thy heart. And Savitri replies, when I have loved forever, I shall know. Love in me knows the truth all changings mask. I know my coming was a wave from God.
Thank you.
Many of you have heard these words over the years, but I close this month of divine love with Savitri's last words. When the crowd, and especially one sage, wonders what high change has come in her, and she replies, "Awakened to the meaning of my heart, that to feel love and oneness is to live. And this meaning of our golden change is all the truth I know or seek, O sage. To feel love and oneness is to live."
Thank you.
mother once wrote to me. Keep living in you the spirit of consecration, and all will be all right. And I would like this to be the motto, if you will, or the theme for the Om Choir. Keep living in you the spirit of consecration.